The Tao of Self-Confidence, episode 551.
Welcome to The Tao of Self-Confidence, where I share stories of amazing women who have discovered their inner journey to self-confidence. Visit our website at thetaoofselfconfidence.com. Your inner journey to self-confidence awaits.
Well, hello, friend. Welcome to the Tao of Self-Confidence, where I share stories of amazing women who have discovered their inner journey to self-confidence. I'm your host today, Sheena Yap Chan, and today I have an amazing lady on the show today. She is a professional writer and a content strategist, and I'm really excited to have her on and share her story with us today on self-confidence. So without further ado, I'm going to introduce you to Francesca Nicasio. Francesca, how are you today? Maybe you can fill in a little bit more about yourself to our listeners.
Sure thing. Thanks so much, Sheena, for having me on the show. Hi, everyone. I'm Francesca. As Sheena mentioned, I am a professional writer and content strategist. Some people refer to me as a content marketer, and I specialize in creating and marketing content for different companies, mostly in the retail, technology, and SMB space. Some of my work has been featured in various publications, including Entrepreneur, the Huffington Post, and Thought Catalog, among other things. And in addition to that, I'm also the content marketing manager for a tech company called Vend, which is a cloud-based point-of-sale and retail platform for small and medium retailers.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. And Francesca, what's your cultural background?
Yep. Both my parents are Filipino. I was born and raised in the Philippines, and then we moved to LA about 10 years ago.
Thanks for sharing that. And what'd be your favorite self-confidence quote?
My favorite self-confidence quote. It's actually a quote or a line that's part of a bigger story or a bigger scenario. So I heard this from a girl named Catherine Zinkina, and it goes something like this. When I die and I meet God and I show up trying to be someone that I'm not, God might say something like, Francesca, I didn't ask you to be her. I asked you to be you. And I really love that because it highlights the importance of loving who you are, and just you were put in this earth to be you. And so just be the best version of yourself that you can be versus trying to be someone else.
Thanks for sharing that great quote. And in your own words, how do you define self-confidence?
My definition of self-confidence, and I sort of alluded to this already in my previous answer, but to me, it means accepting who you are and being completely comfortable in your own skin. And so the actions that you take, the decisions that you make, all come from a place of self-assurance versus a place of fear or doubt. And when you do things, you do it because you think that's what's right for you. You think that's the right thing to do versus doing things because you think that's what other people want. So that to me, in essence, is self-confidence.
Thanks for sharing that great definition. And Francesca, what was your life like before your discovery of self-confidence?
So I guess I can start maybe 10 years ago when we first moved to LA, so about 2008, 2009. It was at the height of the recession, and you know, we didn't have a lot of money or stability back then. And I remember I spent months looking for a job and I couldn't land one. And it was very frustrating because I knew even then I wanted to be a writer. Like even back when I was a kid, I always knew that I wanted to create content for a living. So I was feeling really defeated because I couldn't land a job, any job, let alone a job where I had to write. And so, yeah, that was a low point. And I started feeling a lot of self-doubt. And I remember thinking a lot back then that maybe I should have just gone into the medical field, like what most of my friends were doing. However, I was able to move past that. And I'm glad that I didn't give in to those thoughts. So I stuck to my career choice. And at some point, I decided that if I was not going to get like a staff writing job, then I'm going to sort of forge that career for myself. And that's when I started freelance writing.
Thanks for sharing that. And it's not always easy to do something you love, right? Especially growing up where you're always told to just live one way, or, you know, it's like, you know, your parents pretty much tell you like, this is what you're going to take in school. This is what you're going to do to work, right? And like, what was that point in your life when you realized like, you know, writing is for you and you can go out there and, you know, create freelance, you know, writing as a full-time career for you? What was that aha moment?
Sure. I think an aha moment for me was when I decided I wanted to be a freelance writer, but I did not know how to do it. So I came across this book called The Well-Fed Writer by Peter Bowerman. And it was pretty much a roadmap, but it was practically like a blueprint of how to go land how to build a freelance writing career from scratch. So that book had everything from building, like from how to cold call clients, how to build your portfolio, how to make a name for yourself. And so I picked up that book and I started taking action in it. And, you know, over time I started building that portfolio. I started landing gigs and actually getting paid for a living, for writing for a living.
Thanks for sharing that great story. And, you know, because, you know, you were able to have that realization and be able to create a full-time career, what's your life been like now?
Well, I guess being able to do what I love for a living has certainly built my confidence, and it has helped me live a life that's filled with gratitude. I've been doing this writing thing for a couple of years now, but honestly, there are still days when I wake up and I'm still literally at awe at the fact that I get to do what I love every day for my work, and my writing helps other people, and that, you know, I'm surrounded by a lot of supportive individuals, both at a personal and professional level. So that's been pretty great. That said, I'd also like to point out that it's not all smiley faces and rainbows like all the time. There is still a lot of ups and downs, and I'd be lying if I said that I'm 100% confident 100% of the time. Like, I still have moments of doubts and fear, but the difference is these days I'm better at overcoming them. And one thing that I've learned is coming up against limiting beliefs and fear and doubt and moments of, you know, moments where you're not very confident, that's a lifelong process. And the more you overcome them, that's how you build and become more confident over time.
Thanks for sharing that. And, you know, to the woman who's listening to your episode, she may be in her own journey to self-confidence. What'd be that one tip you would give to her?
My one tip would be to, if you haven't done so yet, is to take the time to reflect on who you are and what you're called to do. So do whatever you can to figure out what you're good at, what your unique abilities are, and all those activities that you could do all day, every day. And then just start doing them, start focusing on them, and then see where that takes you. Because like every step that you take towards that direction of doing what you love, towards that direction of, you know, fulfilling your, I guess, your purpose, each step that you take will either take you to the next level or it'll teach you a lesson. But either way, those lessons and those experiences are the very things that will build your confidence over time.
Thanks for sharing those great tips. And, you know, Francesca, if our listeners wanted to get to know a little bit more about you and what you do or check out some of your writing, is there any links or social media profiles we can connect with?
Sure. You can find me on Twitter. My handle is Francesca, just my name, FrancescaSN. So that's my handle. I also have a website, francescanicasio.com.
Thanks for sharing that. And to our listeners, if you want to connect with Francesca, you can also head on over to thetaoofselfconfidence.com and search for Francesca's name. Her show notes will pop up along with everything else that we talked about. And I really just want to thank Francesca today for taking the time to share her story and tips with us on self-confidence. So thank you so much, Francesca.
Sure thing. Thanks so much for having me.
Not a problem. It's really great having you on the show. And to our listeners, be on the lookout for another new episode of Another Amazing Woman's Journey to Self-Confidence, and we'll talk to you soon. Bye for now. Thank you for tuning in to another amazing episode of The Tao of Self-Confidence. Get your free self-talk tape for building self-confidence by visiting our website at thetaoofselfconfidence.com. Your inner journey to self-confidence awaits.